third video in a row now, guys, where my commentary accidentally recorded from the internal microphone. But if you've been watching up until now, you'll know that I didn't want to have to re-record because I really liked how this recording session went. Sorry about this, guys. But I have tried to edit it the best I can to make it sound better.
You guys are so slow. Look.
A Chaos Emerald! You've already found one!
Well now, I may not look it, but I'm a real treasure hunter. Unlike a certain echidna I know.
What? Heh!
Have you guys discovered anything?
Yeah. I received a signal indicating there's a Chaos Emerald here, but...
You mean we've gotta go through there?
If you don't like it, you can stay here.
You've got to be kidding.
Don't be late. Same to you.
Alright, how's it going, guys? I don't know why I said alright. And welcome back to Sonic the Hedgehog 2006. In the last episode, we did Crisis City with Shadow. And it went on for longer than I expected, and I'm not entirely sure how long that episode was. It might have been super duper short. But yeah, and in this episode we are doing Flame Call with Shadow, which, again, very similar level to when we played it with Sonic. It's freaking the same thing, basically. Also, meteorites that are not fair in the slightest, and you can apparently lightspeed dash off these rings, which is something I did not actually know. I've never tried it before. Alright, so again, just explaining to us that we can homing attack off things to get to places and stuff. And thank you! How the hell was I supposed to know that was going to be there? There was no way I could have known that that thing was going to spawn there. Like, there was no way anyone could have known unless they've played this so many times that they just know that it's freaking there. I feel like I was redundant right now. Whatever. Just take you out with my rage, because rage. And give me my 5-ring capsule, and then let me freaking lose it. You know what? Invincibility frames, go! There we go. The invincibility frames last a considerably long time in this game, which can be pretty useful in levels like this where there's a lot of lava or hazardous floors that you... Why is it? Oh, hello. That you can just, like, walk across. And for example, a perfect example is the Iblis fight, you guys remember before. You can just walk across the lava. Okay, go back here and get this blue gem thing and press right trigger because it filled up the gauge back there. This allows us to do the Chaos Snap, which basically you can just... Where are the enemies? You can just hold the A button and Shadow will snap to the next enemy, the nearest enemy to him. Or the nearest homing attackable thing. But sometimes it just does not work at all. Also, what is he doing? I can't turn him. There we go. And... as you can see, it's refilling a lot, because it's getting refilled from all these enemies that were taken out. But we're actually going to want to wait around for it to disappear, because this bit right here, that is death down there, and if you fall, and if you do the Chaos Snap, it doesn't work, you're going to fall down there, and you are going to die, and it's instant death, so I'm honestly going to wait for this to run out, because... it's happened more often than not to me that Chaos Snap has failed me right there, and I've just fallen and died. I will, however, pick up that capsule once it runs out, because then we'll have a full Chaos Snap for later on in the level, should we need it. Alright, it's nearly gone. I'm actually just going to leave him in his idle pose for a second, because I'm curious what he does. Okay, so he just folds his arms. You're very boring, Shadow, you know that. There we go. Like this, and let's head on through and hopefully this will work properly. Coming attack. There we go, made it through. If I'd have used Chaos Snap there, he probably would have stopped in midair, and if he does that, he actually just falls like a freaking... he just drops like a freaking rock, and it's ridiculous. Also, thank you, sir, but apparently you can't Chaos Spear those guys. You don't really need it, because they don't do a whole lot of attacking. Alright, what's this? Active platforming? No, we've got to just homing attack off more enemies, because that's how the game works. No actual platforming in a platformer. I was actually expecting to catch that right there too. We're gonna have to jump up all of those things going up the lava waterfall. Sorry, the lava fall, I suppose. It's not really a lava waterfall, is it? You knew what I meant, so it's fine. I believe you didn't know what I meant tonight, just a moment. Probably that one, to be honest. Okay, there we go. Dark Mage for 1-up. Bringing all the lives back that we lost in the last episode because of that freaking homing attack just for some reason not working in that one section. If any of you guys know why that is, let me know, because that was a problem. That was all freaking out. Do that, do that, do that, do that. I like using the Chaos Spear sometimes, just because, I don't know, I just do. Alright, Chaos now, let's go. Get out of my way or you're toasty! I don't know why I said that, but I said it, and now it's on me. Okay. Get out of my way or you're a toasty! Oh, there we go. You down. Get you down. And I missed you. Get back here. There we go. Has my voice gone weird? It feels like it's gotten higher. Did my voice just suddenly get higher? That's weird. I kinda like it. I kinda like the voice that I apparently have right now. That's weird. What happened? What the hell happened there? I don't know. Guys, my voice is going weird. Oh, I'm not going to school. Also, why did I Chaos Snap over here? Oh well, it worked. Get out of that. Thank you. Apparently, he didn't actually snap over to the enemies that time, which is kind of weird. I'm not complaining because he lived, and now we're moving along to- What? What? See, he missed the spring right there, causing him to just fly into space and eventually die. So you know what? Let's wait. Let's just not push any directions. There we go. He did it right that time. What the programming? Enemy? We're supposed to hit that? Oh. I guess we fall down here. Yeah, we do. Okay. This is slightly different to Sonic's episode, I think. I say slightly because... Actually, no, I think it's the same, never mind. We can actually skip those enemies as well. Just head over here, homing attack, and... Volcano, let's go! That sounds like a brilliant idea! Into the volcano we go! But what if I don't wanna find the Chaos Object? Also, that's only gonna make sense if I actually left the loading screen in, because at the bottom of the loading screen it says Find the Chaos Emerald. And if you cut that out, then it's not gonna make sense to anybody. Except now it is, because I explained it. Reasons and stuff. Wow. Okay. Ooh, more Chaos Snap power. Oh, you freaking would. Well, there goes some raw footage of the thing. That's actually really annoying because I'm recording these all as one thing, so they're all one file. All of it, like the past three, this episode and the past two, are all one video file, which means this video file is going to be pretty large. And if I'm going to have to keep the file until I do the raw file until I do the Silver Medals video, I'm going to have to keep all of these gigabytes. Although, actually, now I think about it, I could just render out the section separately where I picked it up. That's exactly what I should do. I don't know why I said that. Anyway. Huh? Yeah, so it's again, just exactly the same as Sonic's. Just glitchy freaking homing attack, just like Sonic's as well. He just homing attacks into those and doesn't let go. There we go. Okay, kill your friend. There we go. Captain Phillips is safe. All your friends are dead. Oh god, I referenced Captain Phillips of all things. I've referenced Captain Phillips a lot in my recent videos, I've noticed. Oh, like the ones with Cameron, because we actually watched it at college. It's a really good film. I recommend you watch that film. Watch the freaking film. Watch Captain Phillips. Good film. Also, Slow Down. Also, Door. I don't think we can go through that door. What is going on? Excuse me, please stop. That is rude. Oh dear. Okay, Shadow jump up on the platform. Turn the camera. Hit the thing. Okay, whatever. Do that. Get some rings. Go back. Go through the door. There we go! Yes, it did take up a lot of time. 8 minutes, 5 seconds, 242 milliseconds, apparently. Is that milliseconds? I think it's milliseconds. How many milliseconds is there in a second? I honestly don't know. Is that bad? Does that make me stupid?
Mommy says I'm clever. Oh god.
Come on. There you go. Rings, thank you. Oh, we have to play as Rouge. Well, not if you jump past her, apparently. Leave everything to me. Yeah, that's just what I want to do, Rouge. Fine. So this is, again, the same section we had with Knuckles. Except now with Rouge. I don't think there's any sections like this in Silver's story, just because, you know, there's no character that has this kind of ability that we play as in Silver's story. I won't spoil who we do get to play as, because again, there's three characters that we play as in Silver's story. Well, the main three. For example, in Sonic's story, we got to play as Silver that one time. I'm not counting anything like that. But, and actually we haven't been introduced to the third playable character in this yet. Or maybe we have. Maybe we have been introduced and we just have, well, we haven't played as them yet, but maybe we've been introduced. Spoilers, sweetie! Anyway, but yeah, so in Silver's story, there's no flying character like, or character like Knuckles or Rouge, so. I don't remember Flamecore for Silver, if I'm honest. I don't remember anything for Silver, because I actually have never finished Silver's story. Also, I fell. Yeah, a little trivia for you right there. Some of Silver's playthrough will be blind for me, or at least semi-blind, because I'm pretty sure I've seen bits of it before. But in general, Silver's story will be pretty much completely blind, because I've never played past, like, the first three levels or something like that. Oh, end of the level, give me a ring. Yeah, give me a ring. There we go. Give me the big ring. 10 minutes? That took us 10 freaking minutes. I think that might be one of Shadow's longest stages, to be honest with you. Also, wow. Oh, that's just, still a B, though, so that's not too bad. Oh, wow. I just went to take a sip of coffee and realized there's no coffee in that cup. Therefore, I can't sip it. Also, I really need to get a new chair. This one is so uncomfortable.
I found a Chaos Emerald.
Don't touch it!
What? What's this?
Yeah, okay, so it's the Iblis fight again. It's identical to the fight to when we face him with Sonic. Just saying. Exactly the same fight. You can do that, go across the lava, he does his funky dance. Why is he doing his... What is he doing? Iblis! Look at this, shiny. Okay, there we go, he's doing something now. I need a ring, that'd be nice. But yeah, exactly the same fight as when we faced him with Sonic, and I freaking died! So, I don't know if you guys really want to see this fight again, to be honest, so I'm thinking maybe it's speed-up time, because I want to keep all the footage in- oh dear. I'll keep all the footage in, I just don't know if you guys want to see it normal speed, so...
Rolling around at the speed of sound, the place is to grow up out of fire, no matter rainbow come down. Just stick around, have to keep moving on.
I don't know the words. Just gotta make my head hurt. I died again. God, I thought I died then. Alright, with that we've beaten Iblis again. I don't think we fight him in this form as Silver. Just because of the way Silver controls, it kind of doesn't work. This fight wouldn't work if you were playing as Silver. Also, is that an S? That's an S, sweet. Awesome sauce. But yeah, so say goodbye to the Iblis Worm. He did. We never gonna see him again. Maybe. Spoilers.
Chaos Control!
I'm just saying that I'm guessing that fire was supposed to be covering Mephiles and not be in front of him.
Shadow. Shadow. Shadow? And he doesn't have a Chaos Emerald anymore.
Agent Rouge? Report your status immediately. Have you retrieved the Book of Darkness?
Well, I'll provide a full report shortly. Right now, I have a priority situation to deal with. I need to contact E123 Omega immediately.
Alright, with that, that's gonna do it for this episode. Again, straight into another level, so I will see you guys next time. Sorry for the abrupt end.